Hello, today's episode is about herbs for dogs. After watching, you will find out what natural remedies can help a dog in many cases. And it's not difficult at all. All herbs and plants on this list are perfectly safe for your dog. And let me tell you, they are well selected for veterinary use. They group biotherapeutic properties and uses into 13 classes. There will be dosage information at the end of this video, so this material is intended to enrich your knowledge as knowledgeable canine practitioner. And to add natural and safe substances to your pet arsenal of help for your pet. And before we begin, I have to give you three main points. The first one, I can recommend a book on herbs for dogs to everyone. The link can be found in my pinned comments below. Second, herbs without natural nutrition will not fully work. They are only a supplement and the next step in proper nutrition. Third, consult a holistic veterinarian before using any herbs. Let's get started. Okay, class number one, stimulants. Herbs gradually change the current state of the animal's body, stimulating and straightening different systems of the body and cleaning toxins in the blood. The wool and skin diseases, rheumatoid conditions, tumors and other diseases, contamination by toxin elements has systematically affected the body. So, herbs and companions and conditions for their use. Alfalfa for arthritis and blood diseases. Bardock, the rheumatoid diseases, seborrhea, inflammatory skin disease associated with an increase in sebum, and pyoderma, purulent skin disease caused by the penetration of bacteria. Clover meadow for tumors and blood diseases. Centella asiatica, another name is gotocola, for dermatitis. Class number two, called anti-inflammatory. Herbs prevent the development of dangerous inflammatory process in dogs. Just be aware, I sometimes say herbs but also mean some plants. The top four anti-inflammatory herbs are licorice, is used for arthritis and inflammatory of the skin. Mahonia honeybush, for reducing inflammation of the eyes, mouth and other mucous membranes. Devil's claw, for arthritis. Yucca shindiger, to reduce joint inflammation. Class number 3. Antimicrobial. Herbs inhibit dogs' reproduction and growth of harmful bacteria, fungi and protozoa. The top 5 herbs are Echinacea, is used for problems with the urogenital system, Mahonia honeybush, for infections of the eyes, nose, ears, throat, digestive tract and urinary tract, Sage, for skin infections, oral infections and gum inflammation, Altea, helps with mild urinary tract infections where there is an inflammation. Yarrow helps cut digestive, respiratory and urinary infections. Class number 4. Astringents or binders. Herbs reduce inflammation of the skin, eyes, conjunctivitis and mucous membranes. Treat diarrhea, colic and irritable bowel. Tone the soft tissue of cats and dogs' urinary tract and urethra. The four best helpers in this. Raspberry leaves are good for conjunctivitis, dermatitis and urine health. Nettle for conjunctivitis, dermatitis. Plantain for dermatitis, inflammation of the GI tract and urogenital system. Slippery elm can be used for irritation and inflammation of the stomach, intestines and bladder. Class number 5. Cardiovascular. Herbs enhance the physical integrity of the heart muscle and blood vessels, regulate blood pressure and improve blood circulation in dogs and cats. Here we will have four herbs. Hawthorn enhances heart function, normalizes blood pressure and improves blood circulation. Ginkgo biloba improves blood flow to the brain, limbs and kidneys. Red string pepper improves peripheral circulation and circulation to joints. Yarrow improves function and straighten the vascular structure of the extremities. Class number 6. Vetergonic. Herbs help eliminate intestinal gas and indigestion and relieve digestive spasm in dogs and cats. All four herbs, namely fennel, dill, peppermint and chamomile, help with dyspepsia, flatulence and colics in dogs. I need to explain what dyspepsia is. It is a sensation of pain or discomfort in upper abdomen. It's often recurrent. Dyspepsia has been described as the disturbance of digestion in the stomach, excessive gas, feeling of early satiety and a sucking of the burning pain. Class number 7. Susin. Herbs create a protective enveloping barrier in the digestive and urinary tracts of the dogs and cats, protecting the mucous membranes from the penetrating of waste and preventing the development of irritation and discomforts. Altea, plantain and slippery elm for respiratory problems, digestive irritations and irritations of the urogenital system. Ginkgo biloba is used to help with urinary irritations. Class number 8. Diuretics. Herbs that stimulate urination for kidney dysfunction and water retention problems in dogs and cats help remove toxins and other excess materials from the body through urine. Here will be three very effective herbs. The first one is dandelion, is the most potent diuretic available. Next one, corn stigmas, help with kidney stones and gallbladder stones. And the last one is shepherd's purse, conveniently keeps the body in water balance and rheumatoid conditions. Class number 9. Immunotonics. Herbs stimulate and support the immune system of dogs. There will be only two herbs. Echinacea, used for early bacterial and viral infections. Yes, you got it right. This herb helps your dogs recover from viral and bacterial infections. There is much information about Echinacea on internet. Among species, it's one of the most well-researched and compelling topics. Astragal is an excellent alternative to Echinacea, especially since this herb is effective in kidney failure. And let me remind viewers that the problem with kidney failure appears in the dog exactly after long-term use of commercial food. By the way, I had one of my past episodes devoted to proper immunity in dog. I explained what is the immune system is, what factors affect it, and how to help your pet live longer and live better. I highly recommend checking it out. Class number 10. Lymphatic. Herbs that support lymph production and circulation, lymphatic tissue production and lymphatic mass healing, such as tumors, cysts, ulcers. They all are helpful in systematically treating chronic dermatitis in dogs and cats. In this class, I will talk about just two herbs. The first one is crimson clover. It is used for GI ulcers and cysts of the genitourinary system. And the second, Middle clover helps thread cysts and skin tumors with enlarged lymph nodes in the animal. After watching my video, you should realize what unique, valuable material it contains. Class 11. Sedatives. Herbs calm and control the nervous tension are associated with the activity of the dog's and cat's higher brain nerve centers. For many dog owners, these five herbs will be handy helpers. Hellebore is used for the nervous anxiety, helps reduce the severity of an attack, and is effective for pain. Valerian, the same, for acute anxiety and hyperactivity, helps to reduce the severity of the attack, effective for pain. Passiflora relaxes and improves mood, is used for anxiety and post-traumatic depression, and is an excellent alternative for animals not responding well to valerian. St. John's wort is for nervous trauma. Sown oats are perfect for dogs and cats as good tonic for the nervous system at the advanced age. Quite a good list of herbs to help animal prune to the excitement of the nervous system. Class 12. Nutritional. Herbs rich in beneficial components are perfect for anemia, mineral deficiencies, and absent animal alternatives. Three herbs with a wide range of minerals and vitamins are nettle, alfalfa, and dandelion. Let me remind you that the best source of minerals and vitamins for a dog is raw organs and meat. It is from this bioavailable food what they best absorb the necessary nutrients. Flaxseed can also be considered nutritious. They are rich in omega-3 fatty acids, but again, the best source of the most beneficial fatty acids in animal fat, for example, the skin of duck, quail, or turkey. Class 13. Wound healing. Herbs promote healing externally and internally in dogs and cats. Aloe vera applied to healed burns, wounds, dermatitis, taken external for ulcers. Arnica for external application to closed tissue injuries. Comfrey for external application to closed and open tissue injuries. Calendula with dermatitis, burns, wounds. St. John's wort for any injury where the nerve is affected. So, now you have the whole spectrum of herbs to help your pet naturally, even for acute conditions.
Кто идет?
Now, it's essential to mention the dosage and duration of therapy. Your companion herbs' exact dosage and duration depends on their specific needs, tolerance, and metabolism. In the other words, how much to give varies from animal to animal. Some individuals are responsive to the smallest doses, a few drops of tinctures. Others need a higher dosage and may not respond to the herb. Therefore, it's ideal for your dog to take herbs under the supervision of veterinary nutritionists. For the basic rule of eating herbs in a cat or dog diet is one maximum of two different herbs at a time. The dosage calculation is based on the animal weight, about the person's importance. For example, if your recommendation for 90 kg adult human is 10 grams, then for your dog weight 9 kg, it would be 1/10 of the dosage, so 1 gram. It would help if you also considered the qualification of the veterinarian recommending the dosage, what literature is he referring to, and what manufacturer's requirements he is following. Remember that even though Carnivorous dogs and cats have a higher metabolic rates than humans. Dosage should be increased gradually. Estimating the dosage as an absolute value would be a great misconception without considering the animal's reaction throughout its treatment. To be sure to read up on the component side effect and cautions. If you went by increasing the dosage of the active natural ingredient, herb, move in steps of plus 10% up to a maximum increase of 50%. If the starting dosage is 20 drops of the substance, herbal tincture, the increase will be by 2 dots up to 30 slides. If the dosage is to be reduced, the reduction is the best started with a 1 or 2 day break in intake. Allow the animal to readjust and only then reduce the dosage by half. The frequency of administration for most animals is 2-3 times a day. Of course, the total duration and course is based on the specific of each animal, but in general, it's recommended to take a break for 2 days each week for phytotherapy for cat and dog. 5 days intake, 2 days break. This will allow you to observe your pet's response to herbal component you are given and elevate any tolerance and toxicity issue with prolonged use. If there are no results within 7 days of increasing the dosage, it makes sense to discontinue treatment and try another herb in consultation with your holistic veterinarian beforehand. It makes sense for a dog or cat owner to keep detailed records of successes, failed attempts, and observations. The most accurate answer to the question how long to take herbs will only come with experience and better study of your animal. This is all the basic herbal information I wanted to share with you, like cat and dog owners. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you are going to support my channel, I will leave links to PayPal and Patreon in the description below. All the best to you. Bye.